Let's take a look at how we can begin to shape samples we've mapped in HISE into a custom instrument. We don't have the time to create a comprehensive instrument from our samples, but we can show you enough of the basics so that you'll form an understanding of how to add stuff on your own. Let's make some space by clicking the Map Editor and Sample Editor buttons to close those views. Now let's take a look at what we already have. We'll click the Gain button in the sample container. This reveals a simple envelope module. The simple envelope is a two-stage affair with control over attack and release times. As you'd expect, these parameters define how long the sound takes to fade in and out, respectively, when a note is played and released. This is a modulation source and can itself be modulated. Clicking the Attack Time Modulation tab reveals that no mod sources are assigned at this time. Rather than adding a mod source to our simple envelope, we're going to add an entirely new module to the sampler chain. Let's close Attack Time Modulation, but leave the envelope in view. Now, we'll click the FX button in the sampler module. An empty effects chain will appear. We'll click on the plus sign in the effects chain to add a new module to the single path. We'll select the polyphonic filter from the drop-down menu of options. The polyphonic filter duly appears in the FX chain. We'll play a note or two, twirling the frequency knob so that we can hear what the default biquad LP mode, or low pass mode, does. The resonance, or Q, is inactive in this mode, so let's use the drop-down filter type menu to select a Moog LP filter. This one is obviously based on Moog's legendary four-pole design with all the squelchy resonance we might need. We'd prefer not to be lumbered with a static filter, so we'll click the Filter's Frequency Modulation tab. To add a modulation source to our filter, we need to click the plus button on our Freq Modulation module. We can then choose a mod source from the menu tree. We'll go to the Envelopes subcategory and choose AH-DSR. A new module will appear in the chain, this one a more complex envelope than the simple envelope used to control the sampler's gain. Now let's crank our filter's frequency full and let the new AH-DSR envelope module do the heavy lifting. For now, we're going to collapse the effects chain. Let's now add an effect to the entire instrument. We'll do this by clicking the Effects tab in our Master Container. Now, we'll click the plus button in the newly revealed effects chain and select the Delay Processor from our options. That's probably enough parameters for our basic instrument.